everybody. Welcome back. We are going to start embellishing today in this video. And we've got a lot to do, so I don't know as we're going to get it done, but we're going to definitely get started. We've got the mats on, and it's time to plan everything else. I have a vague idea what I'm going to do with the cover, and I've set aside some things for that, but I'm going to go through and show you some of the things that I have to work with. This is going to be a paperclip that I'm going to make. I did have the ephemera pack, and what I did is I divided it. I opened it up, took everything out, and divided it into types. So I've got these little cards, and there's another one, but I've set it aside for the cover. There are these, most of these are like little sayings. I put this little strip of moons in this same pile because it's about the same shape. And I think I'm going to take this Moonchild one and set it aside probably, or just not use it. But I think what I'm going to do is put it there on the back. So that's the sayings. I'll get those off to the side. There were some little flower clusters, sort of cut apart things. There were some butterflies and hearts and moths. Okay, those to the side. And then there were, some of these were circles from the pack. Move these aside. These were circles from the pack, or semi-circles. And these three were the circles that I cut out when we made that one page with the window. So I've got all of that together. And I think we're going to use those on this paperclip. Let me show you some other things I have. Now, I don't know if I'm going to use these things, but I have them. I have this hand-dyed silk ribbon. I think the color's pretty good, so I might use that. I have, in addition to the flowers that come with the collection, I pulled out some other flowers that might or might not work. I've got a lot of them. Here's some more. These are kind of neat because they're shiny. Oh, that one doesn't go there, but and this book's got a lot of sparkle, so that might work. And then I've got these light bulbs, which I really like. I've only used one of them. The sayings on some of them are a little, I don't know, off, but I like create, inspire. Actually, I like most of them. Just enjoy seems kind of odd. And then I have these frames, and then I have the flowers and things that I showed you earlier that came with the collection, and some other things. Most of those are set aside for the cover, so we'll look at those in more depth when we get to that. Now, I have already made some of the inserts for the side pockets and whatnot, and we'll deal with those as we get to them. I may put my cutter up on the table because we're going to have a lot of things to mat. So let's just start at the front. I'm going to do the cover later because it's going to add quite a bit of bulk. All right, this is pretty decorative already. So I don't know that it particularly needs anything much, but a flower or something might be pretty, or it might just detract. I love these little, they're almost like water lilies. Let's see. I'm just looking to see how it would. That would be fine. We'll put that there with, let me see. Those, and maybe card. Like that. That's kind of pretty. What do you think? I like that. And I think that won't add too much bulk. Alright. So I'm going to put these in. I hope you can see. Alright. So I'm going to put these down here. That is sort of in the in the pattern that I made, so I put them in the right place. I'm gonna ink the edge of this card a little bit. It's not really necessary, but I'm going to. All right, so I had that about in the center. This is, if you remember, this is a pocket. It looks like a belly band, but it's not. It's two pockets. Oops, hang on. I don't want any glue. I'm gonna figure out. I don't want any glue in this corner or this corner. Okay. I didn't glue anything that I shouldn't. It's fine. Then we're going to put these down there, kind of like that. And for that, I'm going to use my Fabri-Tac. So we'll start with this one. This would have looked nice if I'd put it up on a little foam tape, but I didn't really want to add too much bulk there. I have a feeling this is going to have be a pretty chunky book. There's all that. And let's see, we have these little gems. Oh, a couple of these might be pretty. We got so much sparkle already anyway. Let me think. What do I have here? Maybe use some glossy accents to hold that down. It's there's some adhesive on the back of those little sparkly dots, but they're from my stash. I have no idea where I got them. That's not enough to hold these down. Oh my goodness, I used way too much. Some little ones of those. Hang on, I think they're in here. They're not the same, but some little jewels. Let's put a dot. I don't know how much of this I put down. Good. And add a third one right there. I'm probably going to add a third one. I don't like to add two of anything, but I'm not sure where to put it. Whoops. Hang on. Let's pull where I can see it. Yeah. All right. We're just going to put a I'm making a mess of that. That's all right. Okay, there we go. All right, that's going to take a minute to dry. So while that's drying, let us take a look over here, and we'll talk about this insert. If you remember, this is a pocket. This here is a pocket. So we need an insert for it. So this needs to be, I already cut it, but I need to cut the mats, or at least one mat. This is 4.5 by 3.25. And I just used my corner chompers from We Are Memory Keepers. I used the 1/2 inch here and I used the scallop there. And so I'm just gonna put a pink cardstock photo mat on the back. So that needs to be 3 by 4.25. So then I just need to do the same thing to the corners of this. So I use the 1/2 inch on the lower corners. And then the scallop on the upper corners. And I could use pattern paper on these, but I'm starting to feel like I think I mentioned last video, there's a lot happening here, and I think it's I'm gonna be conservative with how much more pattern paper I use. I have plenty of it, I'm not worried about that. I'm just worried about it. The book just, I'm gonna use a grommet on this and also some ribbon, I think. We'll see, because it's gonna go down in there, but it's gonna be, there'll be a space because of the flowers. I don't know if you could even see anything I just pointed at. All right, so let's glue this down. I'm using my art glitter glue. Now, we want to, I'm using a lot of these We Are Memory Keepers things, but of course use whatever you have for rounding corners or whatnot. I think about these bows, we might use those. Where's my pen? If you've got some of the tags from Graphic 45, they might work. I'm just thinking though, I don't think craft would look good. We don't have any white, and the only other color is black, which would probably clash with this blue. So I guess not on those. All right, so I need, okay, this is 3.25, so that's gonna be 1 5/8 is gonna be the middle. It doesn't have to be perfect. You just give yourself an idea. Okay, there's the little hole. And let's grab a grommet. Bright silver one. Oops, did I not make the hole big? Alright, hang on. That did not want to go in. Do I need the bigger side? I think I need the bigger side. Okay, hang on. I'm going to. There we go. Now, if you haven't purchased this because you think you don't have the hand strength for it, I have no hand strength at all, and it works just fine for me. Okay. Just. And then we'll put a little piece of ribbon. What shall we use? I have this dyed ribbon. I have a little bit of white, but I don't have any white in this book, so I'm not going to use that. I have this silk ribbon, which is almost a peachy color, but it's a nice match for that mat. And then somewhere in this pile of stuff on my desk, I have the pink seam binding. There it is. I'm going to use this peach silk. All right. Grab my, get this out of the way. I'm sure we will use that. I'm just going to do a little folded loop. I hope I cut that big enough. Definitely could have cut that a little bit longer, made my life easier. Hang on, pull it back where I can see it. I may cut this again because that's kind of, it's definitely kind of short. Although there's not a lot of room to play with there. Let's see. It might be all right. And that goes like that. Oh, that's cute. Now, one thing that might be cute, because this shows, hang on, let me pull this down where you can see it. All right, so this is going to go in like this. I hope you could see that, right? And you know what I could have done, it's too late now. I could have just put a very short strip of pattern paper there. I don't think it needs it though. I think it's fine. Oops, make a mess over here. Okay, so there's that. Those things are pretty well stuck. Now here I need something for in there, and I just pulled out this. I'm probably going to go through at the very end and make a whole bunch of photo mats, all the same size and shape, and just stick them in. So I may just wait for that. I do like this, though. Just a square. Sure, let's go. Let's mat it. All right, so this is 3.5 by 3 5/8. So I'm going to take an eighth off, so it's 3.5 by 3.5. Then I'm going to cut a piece of my blue cardstock, 3 3/4 by 3 3/4. All right. Then I'm just going to mat that. And this is just a scrap of the pattern paper. That's all it is. And then I think what I'll do is put a piece of the pink cardstock on the back. So this could be like for, you could print out an Instagram photo or something like that and put it on there. Or do some journaling. I do with my, there it is. Okay, and then let's do the back in the pink. If I wasn't doing this on camera, and I probably won't do it all on camera, because like I said, it's going to take a long time, I would just sit down and make a whole bunch of these things and then decide afterwards where they're going. Then I put that in there like that. But let's mat this. This is just one of the cut aparts. So I need a mat 3¼ by 4¼. Victorian velvet distress ink is what I'm using. I probably did not focus, but okay. Sideways too if we wanted. Okay, now this is going to be the side pocket insert. Okay, so that's that. This just came out of here. And you need a piece. Get this out of the way. Put my pin in. You need 3 of these. So you need a piece 4¼ by 5¼. And I use the scallop on the top two and the round on the bottom two. So I'm gonna do the same with the pink. What did I say, 5¼ by 4¼? Yeah, so I need 4 by 5, and I'm gonna need 3 of those because I've got 3 of those side pocket inserts. Okay, so I need to scallop 2 corners and round 2 corners. And they're the upper and lower, make sure you use the narrow side. The half inch side. Okay, now let's get all 3 of those inked. I have 3 of these. Just need to get my hands on the 3rd one. Oh, I had this in the pocket with one of them because I want to use it, so I need to make a mat for that as well. Alright, let's just go ahead and do these. Okay, oops, that's not straight. Wouldn't be one of my projects if I didn't get something down really crooked. Good enough. Okay. Let's go ahead and grommet and ribbon these. I'm probably going to fast forward through some of this stuff so you don't have to sit ad infinitum watching. That is going to look super cute sticking out of the book. And that one goes back here. Go. All right. Okay, that's those. Feel like I should round that. I should have rounded the mat too, but I didn't, so there we go. I'm just going to use the quarter inch round. I just feel like the rounder corners hold up better. They don't take the same abuse. There we go. Okay, and on this side we have the same thing here. Let's go ahead and I need to mat that, and I need to mat this. So let's see, this way. All right, so 3¼ by 4¼. And this one is 5¾ by 3¾. So let's do this one first. So 3¼, 4¼. And this time I will round the edge, 1/4 inch. again, that could go vertically or on its side. All right, okay. And then we have this one. So I need to cut this 3 3/4 by 5 3/4. Now, how do we want to do this? Do we want to round it? Yeah, I'm going to round this with a 1/4 inch round. Okay. And let me touch up the corners. Cool too. This is quite large, so you're not going to be able to put it. I'm going to show you. Oh, where's my pin? I have lost my pin. All right, so this will not fit here. The only way it's going to fit is sideways sticking out. That means it's going to have to go in one of the side pockets with one of the side pocket tags that we made. So what I'll do is put it in behind one of them like that. Okay. All right, so, and I'm okay with that. Or the other thing you could do with it is you could put it in here and just let it stick out. But I think I like it better in the side pockets. It's going to drive me crazy. Let me see. There's that inside of the pocket has the tab at the bottom, so it doesn't want to go in. I'm not going to fuss with it. Okay. Oops. Spraying things all over. Okay, where are we at? All right, so we did this. We did this. We'll need a tuck spot for this, maybe, or we'll just leave it. I'll decide. This has, I just threw this in, but I don't know if I'm going to keep it there. I may just put some photo mats there, so I'm not going to worry about that. This doesn't get anything unless I want to add some ephemera to it down the road. Okay, so we need to mat this. Actually, no, we don't need to mat this. We just need to round the corners. This is going to be a little booklet. And again, we're going to use the, I think we'll use the 1/2 inch on this. Okay. This is just two of the cut aparts that I didn't cut apart in the middle. So we ended up with a little booklet. And we could add matting to the inside, but I've got so much bulk, I'm going to take whatever opportunity I've got to avoid it. Okay, so that goes in there. And then we do have this little guy that needs to be matted. This is like 2 1/8, so I could cut it to 2 by 4. Doesn't seem right. Did I measure that wrong? I measured that wrong. That's going to be 2 5/8 by 4. What earth was I thinking? That's better. All right. Okay, I'm gonna quarter round. We'll do that on one of them. Whoops, what on earth? These little guys are the little narrow ones, and I think I'm gonna put grommets on those. These, however, oh here we go, quarter inch. We're gonna do the same thing, quarter inch. Generally what I do, and you're seeing it right now, is I will go through the book, make everything I need for inserts and whatnot, and then I'll go back through again, and that's when I'll add tuck spots, pieces of ephemera, things like that, the embellishment pieces. Okay, do I want to put grommets on these? I don't think I do. I got enough going on here. Put that one there, and that one there. A little wiggling because of that tab down inside. There we go. Okay, there. Okay, and we've done our side pocket tab. This one's plain. This one I just tucked a scrap in the pocket. Again, I'll probably just put photo mats there. You see that? Okay, this one's gonna need embellishments. So we'll wait, we'll come back, we'll add the embellishments. This one has a little cut apart in it. What's back here? Oh, that's the, whatchamacallit, that's the pop-up. Okay, so let's do this one. I should know this, I've done a bunch of them. 1/4 by 4/4. Could get pink cardstock on the back, which I might go ahead and do at some point, but this is taking long enough as it is, so we have to wait on that. This for now. I just set this one aside because I thought I might use it, so I'm going to put it in my embellishment pile. I love this girl. All right, so let's get her. need from that. Same thing, 3¼ by 4¼. Forgot I have that one too. You should have a pretty good idea what I'm doing. I'm just going to go ahead and finish all of these, and then I will be back. Hi everybody, welcome back to the final video on our Moonchild album. As you can see, I've gone ahead and everything's finished. I'm just going to do a walkthrough with you and show you all the various embellishments that I did. This is obviously the cover. This is one of the ephemera pieces, and let me pick it up. I don't know if you can see. I mounted it on just a piece of chipboard. Let me pull one out. Yeah, just this stuff. But I took a black Sharpie and went around the edge so you can see it. And that's all that is. Underneath this is a piece of printed vellum, and it came with these flowers. Prima has started including little extras with their flower packages. And this was the one with this one. Hang on, let me see if I can. Here's the scrap. I just ripped it by hand, ripped it out. Glued that down, inked the edge, glued it down. Added this. And then everything else is just flowers and leaves. And almost all of these came in the package of the Moonchild flowers and leaves, I think. The only one that didn't is this white one under the butterfly, and you can't see it too much. I just needed something to lift that butterfly up, so I added that one more flower. And on the back, I just have plain paper, or on the spine rather, and on the back, it's mostly blank. I just took from the ephemera pack and glued this little Moonchild label down across that piece of tape that I think I've mentioned several times I don't like. And then here's the closure, which we talked about. And I did glue a little jewel onto the closure. And you could tie a bow or something on here too. I've done that. It just didn't seem like I really had room since I went kind of hog wild with this album. So let's open it up. And here on this page, which you remember it flips out, I put just three little flowers. These, I'm not sure where this came from. These two, I believe, are from the Prima Misty Rose collection. I added a few little jewels and a piece of ephemera from the ephemera pack. I just glued all that here. And then I just tucked that in the one pocket, but there's still this pocket. And then I ended up putting this in this pocket. And it really is too big, but I like it, so I'm leaving it there. And then we already did this one with the insert. Again, all I did is what we did together, is just matting all the various photo mats. This was from the ephemera pack. I didn't mat it. This little gypsy love song was from the ephemera pack, and I just made a tuck out of it. I just glued just this end down. I didn't do much embellishing because there was so much already going on with the album that it didn't really need it. Here I glued just one little circle from the ephemera pack, and then this is the circle that was left over from when I made that page that had the window in it. I glued the little Stay Wild here. Here, I didn't do as much as I thought I would. I just put this little tag from the ephemera pack and this butterfly. I thought about putting something else over here, but honestly, I kind of liked it the way it was, just kind of simple. So I left that. And then here, if you remember, I was going to make a paperclip, but I foolishly pulled out the no stick paper before it was finished drying, and I ended up ruining what I was gonna make. So I remembered I had these pretty bow clips, and that's all that is. And, oh, I did add, let me show you, on the pop-up, I just added this little moth right here. Just be very careful when you do that, that it doesn't stick out when your pop-up is folded down. You can see it's, well, you can't see it, but it's just right there. Okay, and again, this is just a piece from the ephemera sheet, ephemera pack. Same with this. I just put this little moth here, and there's nothing in here. So that is all that I did for this. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this clip back. All right, and there we go. So that is that. And since this is so short, I'll probably go ahead and tack this on to the end of the last video. And that'll be that. I was gonna do it as a separate video, but really it's like 5 minutes, if that. So I'm gonna put it on the end of the other video. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this series. Stay tuned for the next one. And please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section down below. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you don't miss my next project. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.